What is up, guys? It's Tony here, and today we are bringing back the long-anticipated, long-awaited montage editing tutorial series. It's been a long time, and I really miss making these videos, but for a long time there, I was kind of out of the editing scene, and now I am back in. I've noticed a lot of people wanted these videos. They also wanted After Effects tutorials, which will be coming soon, I promise. But before we get to the tutorial today, I'd like to mention that this is a show proposal. As you guys know, over the last few videos, I have been doing proposals for future shows that will be a weekly scheduled on a weekly scheduled basis. So if you guys want to see this on that weekly schedule and you want to see this every single week, go ahead and comment below, and I'll make sure that this video and I'll make sure that this video will be seen on a regular basis. If it doesn't get enough votes, then it'll be more of a occasional basis where maybe once a month, maybe once every 2 weeks. You'll see an episode of this, but if it does get voted in, it could come to the point where it may show up twice a week even, which is really nice. Basically, today we're going to be doing a quick tutorial on what's called, there's a lot of names for it, but the main name for it is Field of View, and I think the more technical name is racking or defocusing, artificial defocusing. And basically, it's something that, really, to be honest, is very, almost impossible to do on Final Cut. Almost impossible. Almost. But fortunately, there's a really cool method, a really cool way to do it that does take a bit of cheating of the Final Cut system and a little bit of, finickiness, if you will. But the one thing you definitely are going to need, which is kind of a bummer, I know, but there's workarounds. I'm sure there's a way you can find, get this for yourself. Maybe contact the company and see if, you could say that you make videos and maybe they'll send you the plugin. Maybe you can find a way to get it from a friend or something like that, but you need a plugin. You need a plugin. This is the plugin right here. It's this plugin called Advanced Masking 2. It comes from FCP Effects. You can find their website in the link in the description below. And it's a really cool program where you can do some masking. Masking is actually something that is native to Final Cut. It's actually in the Effects tab, and you can actually do it all day long. But unfortunately, you cannot change the blur settings, you cannot change the opacity settings, and a lot of other things that are important for doing defocusing and racking. So, today, we're going to be showing you guys how to do the Field of View effect on Final Cut Pro, which is huge because, to be honest, I don't really know a lot of people who know how to do this on Final Cut Pro. I may be one of the few, which is really cool, and I think it's actually bad. I think more people should know this, because it's a very important effect in editing. And not only in Call of Duty editing, I mean in everything. I mean, people use this for color correction, people use this for blurs. So basically what you do is you grab the mask, and you start putting it on. You basically, it's very simple, it's very, elementary almost. You basically just go ahead and drag these things around the shape, and you create your own custom shape. And this tells the program, hey, this is where I want my mask to be controlled from, in this region. And this allows you to change the effect of this region, effectively. And I'm just going to come down here. You can be really sloppy with this, and it'll still create the same effect in a very, very good manner. Actually, I'm going to be a little bit more precise on this corner because I want it to look really nice for the video. To be honest, I mean, you guys should put much more time into this than I am. Of course, I am limited to time because I'm making a video and I don't want it to be too long and whatever, you get the point. So, if you are taking this seriously, I would recommend putting a little bit more time than what I'm putting in to make sure it is precise. So I'm going to go ahead, bring this down. And we're almost done here. As you can see, even when you are being precise, it is a quick process. It's not that bad. Unfortunately, I'm getting locked onto here for some reason. I don't know why it does that. Gotta love Final Cut. Anyway, so you go into, once you got your mask going, you go into the Inspector tab. And in the Inspector tab, you'll find all of these wonderful settings. You do not get these with Final Cut, which is why it is extremely useful to have this plugin. The first thing you're going to want to do when you're doing a defocusing, racking type of effect, you want to turn the outside opacity all the way up. The reason why is because you want to be able to see everything, obviously. You don't want it to be as obstructed by the darkness, but you can have like a darkened effect out on the outside if you want. If you want to make, like, for example, you take the inside and make it darker and make everything look brighter on the outside. That's color correction. You can do that if you want. But for this video, we won't be doing that. What you're going to want to do is turn up the blur on the outside. Now, as you can see, turn the blur all the way up. It looks really artificial. So we're going to turn it, you know, really, to be honest, with this racking, you know, you just got to turn it up a little bit, not even that much at all. And I just clicked out of the effect, or the clip. I don't even know what happened. Where were we? I think we were here. Please don't ruin this for me. Oh, did I hit Z? I think I did. There we go. I got it. I fixed it. It's all good. But I need the inspector back. Where's the inspector? There it is. Okay. Troubleshooting. Technical difficulties. Sorry about that. So basically, there you go. There's the effect. It looks really good. There's actually one thing you're going to notice, though, when you click off. It's very hard. And what I mean by hard is, actually, it looks really good in this video clip. But there's actually like a really sharp edge, and sometimes you'll see the sharp edge where there's a blurry side and there's a, you know, a focus side. And the reason why that is because, to be honest, it's just a straight line. It's not as rounded, edged, and as perfect as, like, say, a green screen. So what you do when you want to fix that is you just simply change the feathering. And the feathering is right here. So you can turn that feathering up slightly, and it'll change the way it is blurred. The other thing you could do is you could change the fall off, which is also really good because you could change, if you take the fall off down a bit more, it's more distanced, and you can have a more progressively looking blur. It's kind of hard to see because this is actually a really good mask. I don't know why, for the first time I've done this so perfectly, and it's on vid, which is kind of cool. Otherwise, the other things you could do with this is you can start to change the defocus gain and things like that, which makes it look more realistic if you're into that, which basically, you know, blows out colors, bright colors in the blur. I can also turn that down and have less bright colors. Just keep it in the middle for me. And the other thing you can do, which is really cool and important when you're doing this type of stuff, is you can have animated blurring. Okay, now this is an interesting thing. What you do is you keyframe right before it's about to blur, and you turn down, whoops, I did the wrong thing. You turn down the blur on the outside all the way. And you move forward a few frames, whoops, I didn't keyframe that. Make sure you keyframe it. And then what you do is once you get to that point where you want to start blurring, you keyframe again, and you bring the blur all the way up. You really rail it out. Actually, I think I should go to here and then move forward a couple more frames. And then bring it all the way out. Then, when it comes into, you know, shot, like here, you want to kind of tone it back down to the normal amount, where it looks kind of proper and it looks more like a well-focused camera. All right? And then at this point, I would start to put a bit of slow motion. So let me just get some slow motion going here. I think I just hit Command-D instead of Command-R. So it's going to export, which we'll just cancel. But what you're going to do is you're going to grab this, and you're going to retime it out. If I can grab it. There we go. And what you're going to have here is like a nice focus in, too much, focus out, and then it's just perfect. Now, one of the things you're going to notice is the feathering is a bit off. As I mentioned earlier, you can just change the feathering a lot. And the other thing you're going to notice, which is something I want, was intentional, is that, you know, at this point where it starts to, you know, defocus and things like that, you can see it's like framed out to this like sniper that doesn't exist yet. What that means is you need to start doing something called keyframing, which is annoying. Trust me, it's annoying. But you have to do it. That's part of editing. And keyframing is where you basically take the mask position and you just move around the mask and you make it fit where the sniper is now, one by one. And obviously I'm not going to sit here and do this forever. And then you'd move forward, and then you'd frame it again, and you'd start moving them again, and you'd reframe it to here. So basically you can see that's kind of the point of it, is in the movement you want to make sure that it is keyframed properly. And as you can see, it looks pretty good. It looks, you know, pretty nice and defocused. It looks very professional. And it's actually a really good effect to add to your montages. Now, I'd recommend for beginners, I would recommend still framing the hell out of a clip. What that means is, see how, like, right here, it's very super slow motion? You just go into optical flow, make that, you know, optical flowed. Or you can use Twixtor if you have Twixtor on your, editing program of choice, of your Final Cut Pro, like I do right here. And you just Twixtor the hell out of that, and then you just defocus that one part. Because as you can see, it really doesn't come out of frame. So it actually looks very well defocused the entire time. The reason why I recommend that is just because really keyframing, as you saw earlier, to a moving object is very difficult when you don't have motion tracking, like on After Effects. But it does look very nice when you slow it down enough. So that's pretty much it. That is my quick tutorial on how to do a quick racking effect or defocusing or field of view. And if you guys enjoyed the video and you want to see more of these in the future, go ahead and like this video and comment below, because right now it means more than anything to do that, because of course I am working on getting show ideas in for my future, the future of the channel. And if you guys want to see this as one of the show concepts in the scheduled shows for weekly videos, you definitely want to comment below and like this video to tell me you want to see more. That's pretty much it. I hope you guys enjoyed the video, and I'll see you guys next time.